Of giving back something that over the past 4.5 years has been very close to my heart, both at work and after I got home. The joy is for the pleasure of being able to pass back to the museum this unique vehicle in what I think you'll agree is an exceptional state of restoration. There will be perhaps more joy from my wife finding over there, for my fear has grown to believe that a pre-war bus is a bigger threat to her marriage and a young mobile girlfriend. She has, as a consequence, developed an intimate understanding of such objects of infinite male interest as half drop-like windows and Rexine curved mouldings. A team of Cobham skilled mechanics used their unrivaled expertise to rebuild the mechanical parts of this vehicle to a standard as good as it was the first day it left London Transport Chiswick Works in 1937. A lot of people were concerned with undertaking that task, and it would be impossible for me to list all of them, although I would take this opportunity to thank the main participants, Bill Cottrell, Andy Baxter, Paul Morris, and Simon Kay, hiding just there. STL2377 was one of a large class of London vehicles and represented the biggest movement from the horse bus body to construction that saw out its end in the traditional bus, such as the Routemaster, which I'm sure you've all seen a lot of on service today, and is now given over to the ubiquitous stretch biscuit tin on wheels. The STL appeared in many guises, but the one that we see here today is that from which the famous RT, behind you here, and the still in service Routemaster was developed. The STL is basically, however, a wooden construction with steel reinforcement, producing a lightweight body that enabled the bus to carry on 2 axles, 56 passengers, and still meet the regulation imposed by the Metropolitan Police in those distant days. This particular vehicle entered service in 1937 at Holloway Garage, J, returning to Chiswick in 1939 for its first major overhaul and the livery to which it is restored today. It returned to Holloway on Route 19, continued its service throughout World War II, travelling around 60,000 miles per year without major overhaul. It soldiered on post-war in London Transport Service until the end of 1953, when it was withdrawn and sold through a dealer to Mully's Motorways, a Cambridgeshire bus and coach operator. Finished its time there some 8 years later on school services. It survived because it languished in the back of Mully's yard for many years until rescued by enthusiasts. It passed through various owners and attempts at restoration before this became stalled, no doubt because of the complexity of the Chiswick construction and the unimaginable drain on financial resources. Cobham Bus Museum acquired this vehicle in 1988, where it joined STL2093, which you can see at the end of the yard, which is suffering from a terminal wood rot illness. These two vehicles represent the only two surviving examples of the standardised London STL. Indeed, with Cobham's STL441, which is behind me here, and the London Transport Museum's STL469, represents the sole remaining examples of the pre-war STL class, although there are a few others that remain converted to service vehicles, unrecognisable as buses, except for the recently restored tree lopper STL1470. So here it is today, looking virtually identical to as it would have looked in the licensing shop in Chiswick in 1939. Without the help of institutions, companies and Cobham individuals, this project could never have even been considered. A generous grant from the Science Museum's Prism Fund, who appreciated the unique heritage of this vehicle, a grant from the Transport Trust, unsecured long-term loans from members, generous donation from members and from the general public, and the help of people with no immediate connection to the bus industry, freely given, has enabled the restoration of this important part of British transport and industrial heritage to be preserved in this way. On behalf of the Trust, and indeed on behalf of the children and adults of the future, I would like to thank some of those who I've mentioned previously on the mechanical side, as well as Ken Abbott and his team from Cox Brothers of Maidstone, who manufactured and assembled the timber framework, Ted Langford of Premier Structures, who fabricated the flitch plates and gussets, Gordon Seagrave of Gaze Marine for the window slides and mechanisms, Lisa Holdsworth, who spent many hours researching, resourcing and eventually finding the original wreck scene, Anthony Gear from my office, who researched and then produced the 1939 interior advertising. All of these people have worked at or below cost, often in their own time. And it is those who make up what we see here today and make it possible. My thanks also go out to Ian Barrett and his team for the rebuilding and the interior finishing, to John Clark for the blind mechanisms, to Paul Morris of PJM Enterprises and his team for the exterior painting, to David Chrysler and Andy Baxter for the rewiring. The list of those who've worked on this vehicle can keep me here for a considerable period. To those who I've not mentioned by name, I offer a sincere thank you to all of you. My job is now virtually complete. I have one task left, and that is to take the invited guests on a quick journey to sample what it was like to ride on an STL. The first time that people will have done so on a London excursion in some 47 years. Before I do that, I have the greatest pleasure in handing over this token key, being the only sort of key that goes to an STL, to the chairman of the Trust, Pete Plummer, as a symbol of its return to service. I'm sure that the chairman will wish to say a few words, and as I've babbled on far too long, I'm sure and hopefully will keep them short. At this point, I would ask those invited guests who have their pass to join us around the corner at the hospitality behind the route master for a brief reception prior to our sample journey. Please have your pass available then and when boarding the vehicle when you return to 2377. Could you please take that at 4:05, that's 20 minutes time. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Is a tough act to follow. What he didn't tell me was, with a key, they converted it to clockwork. And where's the hole in the side? But thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Certainly, this is our biggest day. This is our biggest project today. Certainly, we've got other vehicles to preserve. So throw in your money if you can. You can see what we're worth. It's been a very, very big honour for us today. And thank you for coming. And hope you enjoy our buses. And do remember us, become members, and support us in the best way you can. That's what we're here for. Okay? Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a proud day for the museum and also a proud day for Elmbridge. I'm here just to put a little bit of icing on the cake because we're very proud of this museum. This is a wonderful piece of the last century's history, and it's so great to see that it's being restored and being kept so that people can see it and youngsters can see what was going last century. Difficult to say that, isn't it? Last century, we're in the new one. I think that a lot has been said about the guys that restored this, but by golly, I think they should all get a really big clap, don't you? They're the ones that have done it. Please give them a clap.
Thank you.